everyone, this is Nick, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to make a population pyramid in Excel. And I got this idea from subscribing to How to Read This Chart by the Washington Post by Philip Bump. And a few weeks ago, he posted an article in which he was sharing this population pyramid that shows the indigenous populations comparing men and women by different First Nations in Canada. And I thought it was a really interesting chart. It's kind of like that back-to-back bar chart or the tornado chart, but it's in this sort of connected scatterplot sort of lines right here. And so he actually remade these for the United States population over here in the blog post, and I'll put the link down below in the comments. But population pyramids are really interesting ways to sort of see those distributions back to back. And if there are changes in either of the two groups on the left or the right, in this case, it's men and women, you would kind of see those kind of quickly at a glance with the distribution going all the way down from top to bottom. In this case, we have age distribution. It's from 0 all the way up to 100 plus on Philip's chart that he made. And I'm assuming he might have made this in Excel, but a couple of the things that I was thinking about is how could I use this for my type of data, usually visitor studies data from places like museums and museum exit surveys or guest experience surveys. And so what I thought I might do is create a chart that was a population pyramid for visitor age ranges by two different types of days. So we have free admission day and we have general admission day in our organization or in a museum. And these are just sort of fictitious data, but it's an example of what you might be able to do or how you might be able to use this population pyramid in your data. And so in this case, just like Philip did in his, I kind of created this annotation chart where I see the difference. So on the left, we have free admission and on the right, we have general admission by share of population. So these are the age ranges right here. And you can really see that on free days, we have a much larger share of our visitor population on the days that are free admission days for the 9 to 14 sort of age ranges, those youth. Over here on general admission, we see this nice little curve inward. And over here on the free admission, we have this bump outward. So some things that I wanted to figure out how to do this in Excel, we have the axis, the x-axis along the bottom here, along the horizontal plane, and we have 0 to 25%, but then we also have 0 to 25% going this way. So I wanted to know how I could make it so that these were all positive values instead of everything on the left side being negative values, and I'll show you how to do that. And then the other thing I wanted to know is how we could, since all of these are actually positive values in terms of the distribution, how could I get the curve to go to the left here on for my age distribution on the left side of the population pyramid as opposed to the right. How, since these are both positive values, or I'm assuming these are both positive series of values, how do I get this one to go curve over to the left, and how do I get this one to curve over to the right? And then finally, how do I get the center alignment to be here with the labels without inserting text boxes individually on top of the chart, which would be really tedious. So I'm going to go ahead and we're going to go and make this chart from scratch right inside of Excel. All right, so the first thing that we're going to do is we have our data set up here. These are my age ranges. These are my free admission data. And these are my general admission data. Now you'll see I have a couple extra columns here called Y values and label X values. So for the Y values, you're just going to label that however many rows that you have here. And right now I have 12 rows, so it's going to go 12 down to 1. And then for the label X values, these are always just going to be set at 0. And you're just going to have 0 all the way down the column. So you'll see how we use that these columns of data in just a second. So right now I'm going to insert a blank scatter plot. So put your cursor into any cell that's not highlighting any of this data. Go to the Insert tab, and we're going to go ahead to the Chart menu here under Scatter. And what I want is this option right here, Scatter with Smooth Lines. So I'm going to go ahead and click that. And you can see it gives us this blank chart because we don't have any data. So this is exactly what we want. I'm just going to make it a little bigger so everybody can see what's going on here. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to go to the chart. It's already selected. We're going to right click, click on select data. It opens a select data source menu, and now I'm going to add the series of data that I have here in my source data range. You'll click add, and the series name, I'm going to go ahead and say free admission. For series X values, we're going to go ahead and copy these down, push enter. series Y values, we're going to go ahead and click this column right here and then click OK. Now you can see I actually have one series of data here in my scatter plot. Now we're going to do this for two more. Click Add again, series name for general admission, X values down the row column, Y values down that column. And then finally, I'm going to add my labels, series name, label name, the X values here, all of the zeros, and the Y values. Perfect. All right, I'm getting my scatter plot kind of set up here. Okay, so now I'm going to say OK. All right, now we have our data here. Now let's do a few things with this chart. The first thing I'm going to do is get rid of the chart border. Then what I'm going to do, you can see that we have our labels here from 0 to 14. That was kind of an auto-adjusted label. But let's go ahead and actually, I'm going to keep it at 0 to 14 right now. But what I now need to do is I'm going to get rid of the horizontal grid lines. We don't need those. You see I have two series of data plotted here, my free day and my general admission day. I need one of them to flip over. Now I could go ahead and adjust the axis value right here. Right here it's set from 0 to 25. We could go to the bar chart here and I could set it to negative 25, negative 0.25, that'd be percent. And now you can see I have kind of the bones of what I want. I have this negative 25 section off to the left and the positive 25, 0 to 25 section off to the right. How do I get this data, the free day data, to go over here to the left side of the chart? Now you could type a negative sign in front of each of these numbers. That would be kind of tedious. Or we can use the paste special operator here. So in a cell off to the side, actually up right above here, I'm gonna type in negative 1. And I'm going to copy this cell to put it on the clipboard. So push copy. And now what I'm going to do is highlight all of the data that I want to be negative, go up to the paste special menu, paste special, click on operation. We're going to say multiply. And now what this is going to do is multiply all of these values by negative 1, the value that I put onto our clipboard. Click OK. And now they are negative values. I'm going to go ahead and change those to percentages, unbold. And now you can see I have the population pyramid, the free day section here on the left. That is pretty awesome. Okay, now a few more things that we need to do. What I want here is I want to actually, let's see, I'm going to keep my axis right here. But what I want here is my zero labels. And you can see if we click on that zero line, this is my labels. It'll highlight the label data that it comes from. I'm going to go ahead and right click and we're going to say add data labels. And I'm going to click on the data labels. And now what we want them to point to are all of the label age ranges. So go over to the format data label menu, unselect Y value, click value from cells. And then I'm going to point to the values that I want the labels to populate with. And there's that. Now what we're going to do eventually is we're going to center align them so that they're over this zero axis point. But I really want to get rid of this grid line, the zero grid line. So what I'm going to do is put them off to the right again so you can see this. You can see that my line is still here, the connected line, that green line. Let's go ahead and make it white. And I'm going to increase the width to 2 points. Now you can see that I have this little invisible line. Now the thing is we also have, the scale goes all the way up to 14. So you can see this extra line here at the top and the extra line here at the bottom. Let's go ahead and keep the scale at 0, but let's actually update this to 13. 13.0. And you can see it auto updates to negative 1, but I want to keep it at 0. So we'll say 0. All right, now this is a little bit better, but I still have those extra lines at the top. So what I'm gonna do to fix this is I'm gonna add a little dummy row here. So what we're gonna do is click here, we're gonna insert a row, and then here on the bottom, we'll have an extra row here. And what I'm gonna do is just make the labels, the zero labels go from that top row right there and all the way to this bottom row here. And under the Y values, I'm going to go ahead and add 13 to the top, and we'll add 0 to the bottom. Now let's update some of these series of data. Let's right click, select data. The label name, let's go ahead and edit this. The X values, now I want to include all 13, or actually 14 rows here. And the Y values, perfect. All right, and now you can kind of see some updates happening there on my chart. I'm gonna click OK. And now you can see that there's a white line over that zero midpoint, but all my labels kind of got messed up here. So what we need to do is go back. I'm gonna uncheck value from cells, select the range. And now what we need to do is make sure that we're selecting the entire range, including that top and bottom blank row. So we're gonna go ahead and click this, click OK. And now you can see my labels all move down to the right position. Now for the axis label, I'm gonna go ahead and delete that. We don't need that y-axis anymore. And now my labels, I'm gonna go ahead and select, go to the format data label menu, and then I'm gonna go and center them and center align them perfectly, perfect. All right, now the next thing we need to do is work with the x-axis to make sure that all the values here are positive. So you see the values here on the left are negative and the values here on the right are positive. But we really want them all to be positive. We want this to be 0 to 25% and the one on the right to be 0 to 25%. So to do this, we work with the custom number values. So click on the axis, the format axis label pops up. Click on the bar chart icon here, and we're gonna go all the way down to number, and you can see that it's already set to percentage. But what we want to do is give this a custom value. So I'm going to go ahead and click on custom. And then down here in the format code, you can see that it has this kind of set of hashtags and zeros and numbers and then a comma and then a negative value. First thing we're going to do is get rid of this negative value. And when we do that, that's going to get rid of all the negative values on the left. And then what we're going to do is I'm actually going to just delete some of these numbers so that there's just one hashtag showing. So it's one hashtag, and then I'm gonna type in a percentage sign, and then I'm gonna do the same thing with the other side. Delete this, so there's one hashtag, and then the percentage sign, and then we're gonna go ahead and click on add. Now you can see that it's telling the axis to say, I just want it to be a number. And you can also see since we kept the hashtags there, it got rid of the zero value, which I think in this case is okay. If you wanted to update this, I think you could just type in a zero, replace the hashtags with zero, and then click on add. And then, yeah, you can get that zero back. So if you wanted the zero percentage, we could get that back by doing it like this. So now you have the bones of this chart. I'm going to go ahead and do some editing tweaks. So we're going to click on the axis. I'm going to get rid of the axis line. Let's go ahead and increase the font size here. And let's see, maybe if you want to update those to every 5%, we could do something like that. And now let's figure out how to add some of these extra labels. What I can do here is sort of use the embedded data points in my data series to create a little bit of a label. So I'm just going to isolate this one data point here by double clicking, right click and add label. Right here, it sort of defaults to the Y value, but we're going to go ahead and say series name instead. And that's free day admission. And I'm going to pop that up. And then let's go ahead and make that nice and big. Isolate this one. We're going to make this the label right here. For general admission day, set that to above. Let's go ahead and turn this orange. Let's see, what was this? That was, oops. That was 10 and a half. Oh, let's just make this 11, make them all consistent there. And if I wanted to change the names, you can just change that over here in the source data. So we might want to say general admission, and then it updates in the chart. And then let's go ahead and change the line color here to orange to match. You can update the width, the weight of the line. Let's say that's 2 points. And that looks pretty good, I think. And then if we wanted, we could add a axis title. I'm going to go ahead and click the chart design. And then axis titles here. And we could just type in share of visitor population. Perfect. And you would probably put this into your report or your slide, put a title on there. If I wanted to annotate, so because we know that this ages 9 to 14, if I wanted to give a little annotation, I could actually click on one of these. This is actually the 12 and 14. Let's go ahead and click on data label. But instead of data label, I'm going to say add data callout. And you can see that sort of pops up right here. I'm going to play with that so that it goes off to the left. And then I want no border around it. It sort of defaults to have both X and Y values in here, but what you could do is sort of just drag this up, double click in here and just start typing. And you could say youth visitors aged 9, age 9 to 14, visit more on free days. And then I'm just gonna go ahead and delete the other text there. And then you can work with this text how you normally would. I'm gonna make sure this goes over to the left again. So it's off to the side. Let's just edit this text. And then I'm gonna right align it, or you could right align it, or left align it, keep it like that. And then you have a nice annotation box. You just wanna work with this, move it around a little bit so that you don't get that little white carrot there. Perfect. All right, now this looks like a really nice population pyramid, just like the one that Philip Bump made over here on the Washington Post. But of course, you can see he has lots of different series here, each of these for race and ethnicity. And we could do that if we wanted to. This is just a much more simplified version that sort of compares the population by age for free day and general admission day. But if we wanted to do something like mix it up with, break it down into race ethnicity categories, we could do that and have multiple series here on the left and the right. The process would be the same. You would just want to make sure to put that negative one operator right here and then change all the series that you want to be on the left to be negative, and all the series that you want to be on the right to be positive. And you can sort of keep this, put this right into your PowerPoint slide or your report, and it'll look really, really cool. A super engaging chart to make, and you can do it all in Excel using the software you already have. If you like this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up, and make sure to hit the subscribe button and tap the bell next to it to get notified every time I post a data design tutorial in Excel, PowerPoint, or Word. Remember, you don't need to be a professional designer to look like one using the software that you already have access to and use every single day. I had a great time making this video for you. I hope you had a great time watching it, and I will see you next time.